Hello students, so after your topic of numerical solution of partial differential equations, now your next topic is errors in numerical calculations. Fine, so this is your next chapter, errors in numerical calculations. So in this chapter your first topic is the types of errors. Okay, in the types of errors there are total four types broadly. The first one is inherent errors. The errors which are already present in the statement of a problem. Fine. So before its solution, there is a error in the statement. So such errors arises due to the given data being approximated or due to the limitations of mathematical tables, calculators or the digital computer. Otherwise, if you are taking observations from any apparatus, there can be any limitations of that apparatus. Okay, so inherent errors are the errors which are already in the statement of the problem. Fine. At number two is rounding errors. Rounding errors are the errors which arises from the process of rounding of the numbers during the computations. Whenever you are calculating some value and you are rounding off the terms, then there will be an error that is called rounding error. Okay. Then the number third is truncation error. The truncation error arises whenever you use an approximate result, or we can say there is an infinite expansion and you have changed it into a finite one. For example, the expansion of e raised to power x is equals to 1 plus x square over 2 factorial plus up to so on up to infinity. But in my question, if I have taken e raised to power x is equals to 1 plus x square over 2 factorial, bracket closed. This means I have replaced my infinite expansion into a finite one. So the result that I will get, there will be an error and that error will be called truncation error. Fine. Then at number four, the type of errors, they are called absolute error, relative error and percentage error. Now how to find out this absolute error, relative error and percentage error? Look here. For example, if capital X is the true value of a quantity without any error and X dash is its approximate value. This one is the true value of a quantity and x dash is the approximate value of the same quantity, then the difference between the true value and the approximate value, that is the mod of the difference between the true value and the approximate value, this is called the absolute error. So what is absolute error? It is the difference between the true value and approximate value. Fine. So this is absolute one. Now what is relative error? In case of relative error, it is defined as absolute error divided by the true value. Okay, the absolute error that you have calculated here, this one, divided by the true value. The mod of the absolute error divided by the mod of the true value. This gives you relative error, that is ER. Okay, then the third one is percentage error. Percentage error is relative error into 100. Fine. So this will give you the percentage error. For example, there is a question. A question can come to you in exam like this. That round off the number this one and this one to four significant figures and compute the absolute error, relative error and percentage error in each case. So first, this is my true value that is given to me. So first of all, I will round off this value up to four significant figures. This means I will get an approximate value, right? Then I will find out the absolute error, relative error and percentage error for this true value and the approximate value that I will get by rounding off this up to four significant figures. So first of all, I will talk about this term, my number one case. So if I round off this term up to four significant figures, look here, there are total 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. There are total 5 significant figures. This 0 is not counted in the significant figures, right? So I want to change it into 4 significant figures. So I will convert this 5 into 0. So now here 1, 2, 3 and 4. There are total 4 significant figures. Now this is my true value, that is x. And this one is my approximate value. I can give it any name. I have given here it x1. Okay. So now this is my x true value and this is my x1, that is approximated value. So what will be absolute error? It is the mod of the true value minus the approximate value. This minus this, that it will give me 50. Fine. Then after that we have to find out the relative error. The relative error is the it is the division of the absolute error by the true value, the mod of the absolute error and the true value. So here, so I have written the formula for the absolute error. This one, mod of the absolute error divided by true value. This is relative error. So absolute error is 50. True value is this x 865250. So by dividing them, what we will get? The value for the relative error. I am repeating. Relative error is the mod of absolute error divided by the true value. So absolute value we have already calculated in our first part. It is 50 and the true value is given this one. So this is your relative error. So the third one is to find out the percentage error. The percentage error is the product of this relative error with 100. So if I multiply this value with 100, there will be the power will be reduced to minus 3. Fine. So this was all about this first case. Now in case of the second one here. So in this case, I have to, this is my true value given to me and I have to reduce it into 4 significant figures. Right. So it is 37.46235. So there is a decimal. So I can round off these values. So if I remove this 5, it will become 4. Then if I remove this 4, it will remain 2. Right. So if I remove this 2, it will again remain 6. So I need total 4 significant figures. There are 2 here before this decimal and there should be 2 after this decimal. So I will get 37.46. Because by rounding of this 5, I will get here 4. By rounding of this 4, I will get here 2 only. And when this 2 will be rounded off, it will be 6 only. So it will be 37.46. Right? So by rounding off to 4 significant figure, the approximate value is 37.46. I have told you how we got it, right? So now this is our true value. This is our approximated value. In the similar way, the absolute error is the mod of the difference between the true value and the approximate value. It will be this one. Then the relative error is the mod of the division of absolute error with true value. So by this way, you will get this value. Then the percentage error is multiply this by 100. So by this way, you have calculated the absolute error, the relative error and the percentage error. Clear? Now the next topic is how the errors propagates, the error propagation. So for example, you are having these two true values x and y. And for these two true values, there are approximated values, these x dash and y dash. Right. So for two numbers x and y, these are my approximated values x dash and y dash. Then what will be my absolute error? It will be the true value minus the approximate value. This one and this one. Fine. Now if I want to find out the absolute error in addition operation, for example, if I add these two terms and I want to find out the absolute error in the addition, in the sum. So this means, if I add x and y, I will get x plus y. Now the value of this x can be find out from here. This x dash can be shifted to this side. Similarly, I can find out this y from here by shifting this y dash to this side. So the value for x is x dash plus ex, this one. Then the value for y will be this y dash shifted to this side, that is y dash plus ey. Okay. So now this x dash and y dash can be written together and this ex and ey can be written here. Now this is the sum of the true values. This is the sum of the approximated values. And this is the sum of the absolute error of this x and y respectively. Right. So now by taking mod on both sides, what we have done here, we have shifted this value, the sum of the approximated values on this side, left hand side. So it has become like this, which is equal to this mod of EAX plus EAY, which is less than equal to mod of EAX plus mod of EAY. Okay, this result you have done in your lower classes. So this means the mod of the difference between this true the sum of the true value and the approximated value is less than or equal to the absolute error in this x and the absolute error in this y. Fine. Similarly, the same result you can get in the subtraction operation. That is, if you subtract the true values x and y, so the result will be like this. Now there is a subtraction, so there is a subtraction operation, but here it is again plus y because there is mod. So negative sign again changed to plus. Fine. So now the next one is absolute error to calculate in case of multiplication operation. In the case of multiplication operation, let this EA be the absolute error in the product of two numbers x and y. This means if I take the product of x and y and x dash and y dash, that is this one and this one, then the absolute error is EA. So EA is x dash into y dash, x dash is x plus EAX, y dash is y plus EAY using this result. Fine. And minus xy. So from here, if I multiply the brackets, I will get xy plus x into EAY plus EAX into y plus EAX into EAY minus xy. Right? So xy and xy will be cancelled out. So what is left? X EAY plus y EAX. Here is plus EAX EAY. Now this is the product of the absolute errors, which will be a small value. So we will neglect it. So what is left? The absolute error in case of the product of two numbers x and y, it will be x EAY plus y EAX. Right? This means the absolute error in case of the product of two numbers x and y is x into the absolute error of y plus y into the absolute error of x. Similarly, you can find out the absolute error in case of the division operation. And this will be like this. If two numbers x and y are divided, then the absolute error is equal to this.